I'd be going crazy, I don't know what to do. My heart is screaming for you, babe. And what I'm trying to say is that you make the sky look blue. Hey guys, welcome back to a new studio vlog. I'm Caitlin Bongers and I'm a Dutch illustrator and ceramist. This week has been incredibly cold, most of all. It's been minus 10 degrees and more here in the Netherlands, and there's still a lot of snow outside. And I mostly stayed inside because cold. But I did get to walk a little bit in the snow when I brought out my packages and I filmed that. The rest of the week, I mostly worked on my gouache painting and I made some more palettes. I hope you'll enjoy it. Can't stop looking at ya, you're like a firefly. Guide me out of the woods now. Oh, I think I lost my way, but got you to help me back. Tell me what I should do now. Every time I'm feeling down, you can make it go away. Your light is shining bright on me. Got no reason to be afraid. You're glowing in the dark. You're glowing in the dark. Glowing in the dark. I feel it in my heart. You're glowing in the dark. Glowing in the dark, yeah, you're glowing. There are a ton of things that I still want to try out with making palettes that I haven't explored yet. And also, a lot of the things that I've done before, I want to try more with them. I want to make more palettes with little shapes in them. I want to try out more different colors to make palettes with. And something that I'm working on right now at the moment is I'm using my old stamps that I've made before to try and make the little watercolor pens with them. And then the idea is that the pens aren't as deep, but they're a little bit wider, so that if you use the paint, the shape of the stem will become visible after you've used more of it. So this is something I'm experimenting with. I'm also making new stems that are a little bit more suitable for this specific way of using them. So I hope those will turn out cute. So far they're looking good, and a lot of you guys also said that you really like them on Instagram. So yeah. I'm also working on some palettes that you guys requested. Last shop update, the palettes went really hard, and some of you guys that have shopped from me earlier asked if some designs were going to return in the shop update for the next time. So I'm working on that. I'm working through all the requests, and then after that I'm going to explore again for myself and see what I want to create. And it's definitely a lot of work to get through all these, but I'm still really enjoying it. So far so good. I also ordered some colored clay slips that I want to use to paint figures on my palettes. And I ordered some transparent glaze for this, but that one hasn't arrived yet. I'm also trying out to use a white clay slip on the base of my colored palette, so it will be a little bit easier to mix on them, but I guess I'll show you guys this later so it's a little bit more clear. Of course, when I'm not showing any pictures of what I'm doing, it's not as easy to explain. You're growing in the dark. You're growing in the dark. Growing in the dark. Growing in my heart. You're growing in the dark. Growing in the dark. Yeah, you're growing in the dark. Oh, oh, you can make it go away. Growing in the dark. Oh, oh, you can make it go away. You're growing in the dark. Oh, A big goal of mine this year is to practice more in my sketchbook and work more with different mediums. And one that I've been exploring a lot lately is squash, which I already showed you guys in the last video that I made. So this painting on the left I made in the last video, and now I'm just going to practice some cloud formations. I'm also working on another illustration later in this video, but I'll talk about that when it happens. I've been using a lot of gouache. It goes way faster than using watercolor, and my talent squash paints that I had before were actually starting to run low, so I decided to treat myself and I invested in a beautiful new gouache set that after I've tried it out some more I will hopefully make a review video of. It's the Schmincke designer gouache set, and I also ordered some tubes of the Horrendum line to kind of see how they're different and try them out a little bit more. It's probably too late, but here I am reaching my arm out. I want us to win the struggle we're in. Hey guys, I wanted to talk a little bit more about what's on my mind lately. I have been making these vlogs for a couple of weeks now, and I realize I barely make some footage where I actually talk in my videos, because I'm still very uncomfortable talking to the camera and I never know what to say. And yeah, I'll just try and shoot some videos once in a while, and I'll try to explain what's on my mind. So what I wanted to say is I had some trouble with my shipping lately. Like, all my packages that are going to the USA are having a lot of problems. What I've heard back from my shipping company is that USPS is working with the last in first out system, and what's happening is that they don't want the new packages to get delays, so they're processing the new packages first. But that means that old packages that arrived earlier, still from December, from the Christmas season, they're just waiting there until they have time to process them. So I have packages that are still from, that arrived in America in December, and they're still not processed. And the shipping service isn't giving me anything to work with. They're not going to refund the packages, even though they're all tracked and they all have insurance on them. And normally when a package would get lost, they would start tracking research program, and they would see where the package got lost and if they can still find it, and if they can't, then I'll get my money back and I'll send a replacement to my customer. But now, because the packages are not lost, they're just waiting there, I don't get a refund, and of course I still have customers that are waiting for their packages. So if you are a customer of mine that has ordered for me, your package hasn't arrived, don't worry, it's not lost, it's just gonna take a little bit longer. And in the meanwhile, I'll have to think about what solutions I'm going to provide for my customers, and I'll probably am just going to send out some replacements soon, because packages that haven't done anything since December, it's taking too long, and I just want my packages to get my best my customers to get their orders, and yeah, it's gonna cost me some money to replace everything that's been stuck, but sadly this is what's going on right now, and it's a bit of a struggle, and it's sad that I have to spend money now. I'm finally starting to almost get a livable income, but yeah, I still have faith that once COVID gets a little bit more stable and everything goes back a little bit more to normal, hopefully the USPS is going to work normally again and I'll have no more problems. Hopefully. So this painting was quite a struggle and I didn't get the colors exactly right how I wanted them. Also, my brush that I was working with was a little bit too big to do the most of the details that I was working on. But also I kind of liked that I limited myself to a certain look of strokes by using this little bit of a bigger brush. I don't mean the brush is that big, but still it felt like a limitation. I really like how the grass turned out and how the details there showed up. I am not too happy with how the girl looks and I'm not too happy with how the mushroom and the sky looks. But oh well, it's a practice piece and it's just something in my sketchbook, so I'm not too sad about it or anything. In the end, I really enjoyed making it and it was a fun piece to practice with and I learned a little bit with it, so all is good. I have to remind myself from time to time that not every piece has to be a huge step forward in the art making process and not every piece has to be for a project or to make products of. Pieces can just also be for enjoyment and just relaxing and just seeing where it takes you and enjoying the materials. And that's what I did here. So yeah, I listened to an Audible book and I had a great time. Let me tell you guys something, this video has been a real struggle to edit. I've started editing this video on Sunday and I've worked on it every day and it's now Wednesday. I'm supposed to upload my video today. And I think that starting from next week I'm going to try to do it a little bit differently. I feel like my vlogs are a little bit long and there's a lot of repetition in every week because, well, let's be honest, a lot of things that I do every week are just the same steps over and over again. And that's not a problem for me. I'm quite happy with what I'm doing. But for a vlog format, I'm worried that it gets a little bit too repetitive. And also for me, working on basically the same video over and over again, it's also not that interesting to see myself do the same steps again and again and again. So I want to do some product making videos again. I have some footage filmed where I work on a repeating pattern, so I think that could be a fun video to make. It was originally planned to go into this vlog, but I already had so much footage, I didn't really need the extra footage here. So that's hopefully going to be a separate video. And then starting from the week after that, I'm probably going to make like somewhat shorter vlogs with pieces of footage that are a little bit more dense. So I'll go more quickly through the same material, and I hope that will make it a little bit more interesting. The palettes that are being glazed here right now are the biggest palettes that I currently sell in my shop. These will be available with the next shop update that will be in probably late March. I already got some new palettes back today and I'll be showing them in my next vlog. And yeah, I'm really excited. I think these new ones turned out really pretty, and I'm also happy that I finally have some big ones that haven't broken during the traveling phase. So yeah, I know a lot of you guys have asked for this, and there will finally be some more this time. A friend of mine has made new beds for my throwing wheel. In last video I showed you guys the throwing wheel that came in, and I tried to work a little bit on it, but I had a lot of problem with the plastic beds that were shipped with the throwing wheel itself. So a friend of mine has made some wooden beds for me, and I'm really excited to be trying them out, but I'll have to wait a little bit before I can. Like I said, it's been minus 10 degrees Celsius and lower, and the trains are just not working at the moment. And normally if he would go to school, he could stop on the way and there he wouldn't have to go outside unnecessary, but because of the snow, also the schools have been closed, and it would be unnecessary for him or for me to go outside right now. So yeah, I'm a little bit sad that I can't work with my throwing wheel at the moment, but it's okay. I will have lots of time to practice it with it later on. Before that, I'm just going to focus on making as many palettes for the next update as I can. So in the next couple of weeks, I'll have some more time to do other things, to hopefully make another sticker sheet, hopefully spend some time on my website and maybe making a Patreon. So yeah, that's something that I have on my mind. I'm also working on some mini palettes for some watercolor makers that I have been working with. I'm currently not open for other collaborations. I'm trying this out just with a couple of friends, people that I already knew, and maybe in the future I'll open this up for other people as well, but for now I want to keep it in a safe environment for me. So these are some fun new materials that I've been wanting to try out for a while now. The first ones are the colored slip that I've been talking about. I've debated making some myself at home, since it would be easy to make. Like, you can just make a slip out of white clay and then add pigment to it. But I know that all my pieces were once turned out a different color because someone else did this and they used a pigment that changed all the glazes colors in the kiln. So I didn't want to do this to anyone, so I just thought to play it safe and order them pre-made, and then at least I hope the people who made these know what they're doing, and I won't be experimenting with it. I still really enjoy packing up these packages, although with a shop update it is a lot of work, but with the weeks after the shop update I'll only have like 5 to maybe 6 packages each week, and it's very doable and it's a lot of fun. But after a few weeks it usually drops down to 1 or 2 packages a week, and the fewer packages that I have, the more it will cost me to ship, because I ship in bundles, and then the shipping starts to get too high for me, so I either have to up my shipping costs or I just have to close my shops in those periods of time. And I think for me that closing the shops for a couple of weeks is also a good idea to just give myself a little bit of headspace. So my shop will still be open for another week or two, and then I'll probably close it down until the next shop update date. So just for your information, I will be coming back. There will be more pallets again. But for my own sanity, it's just best to close it a little bit.
forever and ever, just us, just us.
And with that, we're at the end of this vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I make videos every Wednesday, so if you want to follow me, be sure to subscribe to my channel. See you guys, bye bye.